Fuck
now
you.
Now for something.
Fuck you.
Completely.
Morning Star, or a spawn thereof, by Brian Abney. I feel like I am Lucifer, and if I'm not, I'm something quite similar. Been part of the genome pool here and there and here, since long before I can remember her. Walked out of primordial ooze, got to choose, win or lose. I was brave, held on to my body fur. I'm a beast, you see, not separated from the varmint, me. I question what overcame you, who decided one day you were set apart. Divine iniquity, it would seem. You know, I've always felt like I'm Lucifer. And if I'm not, I'm something quite similar. When I was a boy, I proposed a theory that either I was the only one, or there were few of me, few and far between the humdrums of normalcy. This theory eventually set me free, set my sight to see, being blessed be, unequivocally. Strange to say, I've always had a feeling, I felt like I am Lucifer, and if I'm not, I'm something quite similar. In Mother Earth I trust, I have no strange gods before her. In the wild-eyed outspark electric, I believe in nothing. Paid no tuition for intuition, no lip service to the churches or the flag. I pledge no allegiance to a concept predatory. I swear upon my mother's womb, I've tried so hard not to reveal this too soon. But now I must come out, I must break free with all I'm telling her now. I've always felt like I am Lucifer, and if I'm not, I'm something quite similar. Is that okay, or should we do it again?
It's our little secret. Coming this June to contacttea.net. America's favorite twisted babysitter, Auntie Brian.
Fuck you.
Auntie Brian.
Fuck you.
Whoa, what happened again?
And now for something completely different.
question, please?
Chapter 6. As clouds go by. In the early 80s I had the wonderful encounter with two terrestrials, Earth natives as it were, in amongst my extraterrestrial and ultra-terrestrial contacts. I had taken up studying a truly American Bible known as OWASP. OWASP was written by automatic writing at the turn of the century by a dentist contactee. Although I really never dug too far into its very detailed and complicated scripture, I was taken up a bit more from the counterculture movement which sprang up from those who faithfully studied it. This group of people are known as faithists and occupy various nests around the country. Like the Mormons, many of them can be found in Utah for some reason. My initial contact with these faithists came from answering a few classified ads in the back of Faith magazine. Faith was and continues to be one of the quintessential digests for the wayward contactee, like me. One of these classified ads led me to two of the most influential souls I was ever to encounter, Bill and Kathy Cox of Buford, Georgia. They ran what I think must be the last truly underground New Age occult tabloid. It was a musty ink and press Xerox type of magazine that smelled like stuff the United States government might have printed out in the 60s or early 70s. Bill and Kathy were my very first associates contacts, and unfortunately they were killed in a tragic automobile accident in the late 80s before I could ever meet them in person. They were the two who took up interest in my young channeling verse and actually published the very first manuscript I ever put out, As Clouds Go By, in a very flimsy, scattered edition. This included my early contacts Maury Ra and Tyr, and Alicia. It also presented the very first early communiques from the Quim, my ancestral spirit guide. Over the years I have made what I believe to be solid contact with the spirits of Bill and Kathy Cox. And these are the two few that I consider sacred, and I do not share our communication with others. They are quite merry, I must say, indeed. And enjoy soul retray of all arcane illuminaries. Danny Ledford, you old son of a bitch, if ever you happen upon these words, please phone home. I've been dying to reach you. Literally.
in contempt of God. How proper, how quaint, surely indicating stature and class. For God so loved the world, it said, that he gave his only begotten Son, herding the rest of us like sheep into a mass. If we are to believe in these so-called words of God, doesn't that make us automatically signed, sealed, and scorched, unsure of the Master, yet kept and fed and clothed so as to serve him until they rot, until we rot? I don't get it. I never have, and I never will. But many seem to. They seem to be rendered unable, unwilling to give it even a second thought. I know when I look around at the masses, see there ain't no learning, there ain't no learning, they ain't no learning, nothing no wise to deal with their questions. Dropping out as soon as I could, after many telling me what I should, what is good, I upped, I tailed it, long out of there, found good counsel from the mighty oaks and maples, enveloped in the majesty of supreme earth, creeks, hermetically learned, ancient secrets of the holy woods. There is nothing, no one, place, or precious things ever stand up to a magical boy with wings. And if you ever try to, sure wouldn't want to be you. For surely, merely reading my psalm and verse still carries, still potent, still steams. It's been said, very scary, with a zest of zeal and a dash of arrogance, but mostly comprised of half fear, half lust, that a man cannot serve two masters. I beg your pardon, Mr. Man, in God you trust. Leave behind your open hand, your hacking, and your snobbing, and truly you'll always be welcome in my church. If you thinkest I'm a soul for Satan, I'll think, well, ain't that a shame, and can you never been lost to begin with. Much obliged, though, reckon tis flattering. You cared enough to search. I am, blessed be. Care for a little touch of bourbon in your tea? You might think that's fine. Most likely kicks in better than that dull communion wine. I've said my piece. Carry on.
This June to contact t.net. America's favorite twisted babysitter, Auntie Brian.
Fuck
as we
you.
Sign her for a glorious season sitting with you.
Fuck
her
you.
Beans and ghouls every Saturday night.
Fuck you.
All night long. Auntie is the coolest as she always lets us eat tons of junk food and oftentimes
fuck
doesn't
you.
Even know where the fuck we are.
Fuck
perhaps
you.
We are in her creepy attic with Wise and Gypsy,
fuck you.
Two of Auntie loyal familiars who make their home among
fuck
creepy
you.
Spider wimps and dusty old grimoires.
Fuck you.
Mason jars containing eyeballs and testicles.
Fuck you.
I'm not sure. 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 sister Ness, father of Pan-Manus, who wrote you from the Hanai sister Ness, father of Pan-Manus, who wrote you from the Hanai sister Ness, father of Pan-Manus, who wrote you from the I'm gonna pan manage to work here.